Turning to that unfolding story of the Kurt Tippett hearings, and as we brought you earlier, the full penalties for him and for the Crows have just been announced. We go back live to Ian Shuttleworth in Melbourne. Shuts.
Beck, AFL Chairman Mike Fitzpatrick and CEO Andrew Dimitriou are still fielding questions from the media in relation to the fines and suspensions handed down towards the Crows, CEO Stephen Trigg, Football Manager Phil Harper, former Football Manager John Reid and departing player Kurt Tippett. The Adelaide Football Club will hold a press conference in a short while, but this is how the day and the last few moments have unfolded. Taking their medicine after a marathon hearing.
Look, I'm not allowed to comment until after the AFL speak. Sorry.
Were you happy with the hearing, Phil?
Yes.
A fleet of lawyers arguing the case for the Crows for more than 8 hours. This was supposedly the shortened version of the hearing, given that guilty pleas were entered.
This looked like not a systematic breach from our point of view. And so we felt that the decision we've made is right.
Kurt Tippett admitted to his part in the draft tampering, but while he too had a lawyer inside the commission, outside, the former Crow wasn't in the mood to break his silence.
Okay, you're disappointed.
Despite the day-long hearing, the penalties ended up much as expected. The Crows fined $300,000. They've lost draft picks for the first two rounds next year. CEO Stephen Trigg has been fined and suspended for a year, although he will only have to serve half of that ban. Football Manager Phil Harper suspended for 2 months.
The Commission regards this case as a very disappointing one for the entire football community.
Tippett's penalty will cost him matches, but not a club. Likely to be picked up by the Swans in the pre-season draft, he'll sit out the first 11 weeks of the season and has also been fined. His former teammates will await his return. Taylor Walker taunting Tippett on Twitter that he's looking forward to sitting on his head. The tweet since removed. And John Reid, the former football manager, has also been removed. It means very little, though, because he is now retired. The AFL didn't let him get away with it, though. He was slapped with a 12-month ban. Half of that has been suspended, so he ends up with a 6-month ban. As I say, that means very little, given that he is now on the udder enjoying the good life in retirement. Overall, though, the AFL described the Crows' behaviour as disappointing. It says that the draft and the salary cap are fundamental to the success of football in this country. And as I mentioned earlier, we'll stay tuned now. And in sport, hopefully, we'll have some comments from the Crows CEO, Stephen Trigg, and also the chairman, Rob Chapman. Beck.
Thank you, Shuts. Ian Shuttleworth, live from Melbourne.